Tar Sharma from Arya College of Engineering and IT. I am presenting lecture on measurement of solar radiation. I will cover introduction of the solar radiation, need of solar radiation and measuring devices which will measure the solar radiation. Now what is solar radiation? Solar radiation energy radiated by the sun or solar radiation is a term used to describe visible and near visible radiation emitted from the sun. There are four type of radiation which emitted from the sun, that is ultraviolet, visible, near infrared and infrared. Solar irradiation, the radiant energy received on the earth surface. Solar isolation, solar radiation received on a flat horizontal surface on the earth. Now the question is, why we need solar radiation? So it is important to measure solar radiation because of owing to increase the number of solar heating and cooling application. For accurate solar radiation data to predict performance, to know the availability of the solar energy. Devices used to measuring the solar, there are three types of devices which are used for the measuring of the solar energy. First one is pyranometer, second one is pyroheliometer, third one is sunshine recorder. First is pyranometer. It measures the total hemispherical solar radiation. Solar constant, what is solar constant? The average amount of solar radiation received by the earth's atmosphere per unit area when the earth is at its mean distance from the sun. The value of the solar constant is found experimentally to be 1368 watt per meter square. This is the construction of solar pyranometer, and we can easily see the part of the solar pyranometer. Here it is a sunshield, a detector, a glass dome in which detector is placed, a connector, a bubble level, a fixed foot and housing is there, then working. When it is placed in the sun rays, then it receives the radiation due to which the temperature of the surface starts rising. The rise in the temperature of the absorbing surface is detected by the thermopoil. Now the thermopoil generates thermo EMF proportional to the radiation absorbed. This thermo EMF is calibrated in term of received radiation. Now pyroheliometer, used to measure beam of direct radiation. It collimates the radiation to determine the beam intensity as a function of incident angle. It is also known as normal incident pyrometer. This is the construction in which we can see the whole construction, the construction and the working. Use a long collimator tube to collect a beam. Here is a long collimator tube which we can see in this diagram. Now radiation whose field of view is limited to a solid angle of 5.5 degree by approximate, and it is measured by this is called acceptance angle. Now diaphragm inside the tube, inner surface is blacked to absorb any radiation. We use diaphragm inside the glass tube thermopoil. We can see a glass window. At the base of the tube, a wire wound thermopoil having a sensitivity of approximate 8 microvolt watt per meter square. Here it is, this thermopoil at the base of the tube. We can easily see tube sealed with dry air to eliminate absorption of beam radiation within the tube by water vapor. Now sunshine recorder. It measures the duration in hours of bright sunshine during the course of the day. Glass sphere, which act as a convex lens, focus at a sun's ray to a point on the card strip. We can see that a glass ball, metallic ball and the diagram of a sunshine recorder. Whenever there is a bright sunshine, the image formed is intense enough to burn a spot on the card strip. The image moves along the strip due to the sun movement. Image will move along this rotation. Thus, a burnt space whose length is proportional to the duration of the sunshine is obtained on the strip.